We have received an order from Lord Councillor Kimball. The Westfield town of Yulden has been overrun with violence and theft. Our task is to restore order. It seems that mercenaries are to blame, many having lost their patrons in the faction conflict.
I have certainly heard tales of mercenaries left bereft by the passing of their noble masters.
I wouldn't be surprised if Archbishop Joshua were fanning the flames behind the scenes.
Will the princes stop at nothing to win the throne?
Regardless, our orders are clear. Quinn, try to keep casualties to a minimum.
I make no promises.
Quinn!
Every last member of Victor's faction will die! Round up the Starish dogs and hang them high!
So much hatred and lawlessness. All because of the succession dispute.
Enough of this. We must be united against the Empire.
United?
Very well. We shall all be united under Victor.
That's not...
Forget it. There's nothing you can say to change their minds.
I thought the Alliance was bad, but this... I suppose this is what war does to a country.
Enough of the philosophizing. We need to focus on the situation at hand.
Right away.
Go.
I'll teach you a lesson.
How was that?
I'll take you down. Target eliminated. I'll take you down. Next target.
Over there. Understood.
I'll take you down. Be gone with you. Target eliminated.
I understand.
On my way.
I'll teach you a lesson!
How was that?
Over there. Understood.
Watch this. That should do it.
Our enemy has been defeated. On my way.
Be gone with you. Target eliminated.
Yes, that looks to be the right position.
Capture successful.
Over there. Understood.
was that? You thought I was just a greybeard, huh?
I'll take you down. Next time. On my way.
On my way. Over there. Understood.
I'm off at once.
I understand.
I'll take you down. Be gone with you. Target eliminated. I'll take you down.
Right away.
Next target. Got it.
Ours now. Even if we deal with the situation here, it won't solve the deeper problem.
If only Prince Ivangar were alive.
On my way.
I'm off at once.
Over there. Understood. On my way.
I'll teach you a lesson! How was that?
Oh, I can't wait to hear.
Oh, they just died.
Watch this.
Take you down. Next time.
I understand. Right away.
This will serve.
On my way.
It is time. How was that? I was just a greybeard, huh?
It would seem I've grown stronger.
If this continues, the kingdom will crumble. Something must be done.
Thank you for agreeing to meet me. What I'm about to tell you must be kept secret, at least until the time is right. Thus far, you have all known me as Frederick Lester, but this is not my real name. I am. Levantia Shatham, fourth son of the late Rhaegal Shatham.
He can't be.
Fritz? A prince?
Is this really true, Andreas?
Let him explain.
I have kept quiet all this time because I thought one fewer prince would make life easier.
Does this mean... I had always thought that Prince Levantia had been assassinated when he was a child.
The one who was killed that day was Frederick Leicestershire, a boy of my age from House Leicester.
I don't believe it.
How can you prove that this is true?
Look at my arm. This mark only appears on members of the Shatham family. This proves my lineage.
That's the mark of the blessed.
We all bore witness to the destruction that beset Yeldon. I cannot abide this carnage any longer. It is time to fulfill my destiny as the true royal heir. Therefore, to right this kingdom's wicked path, I ask you all to lend me your strength.
What?
Well, that's my
son. How can it be that?
How could Fritz from the royal
that is one creepy
You're
smart.
Really a prince!
Please stop that.
So you're telling me that Queen Fox's leader is an Aladdin?
I'll have no part in it. I'm leaving. I've finally got a glimpse at your true intentions, Rias, and I, for one, shall not be caught up in it all.
Quinn!
The rest of you might want to consider following my lead. Rias, is this really what you want?
The Blue Foxes succeed in calming the situation in Yuldin, but violent conflict continues to rage throughout Deofield. Meanwhile, Archbishop Joshua deploys his fiercely loyal Templar Knights to Turnberry Meadows. Lord Kimble's troops march there to meet them, and the two factions confront each other head on. Elsewhere, the Blue Foxes are called to a meeting where Frederick reveals himself to be Prince Levantia, to the shock of the unit. Unwilling to support Frederick's bid for the throne, Walter Quinn leaves the unit. With the factional battle imminent, the Blue Foxes receive an order to eliminate the Archbishop.
I. However, What's that? I cannot agree. I. Sorry. I cannot agree. However, enough. Sorry. What's the matter, Estelle?
I've come a long way since I first met you, haven't I, Andreas?
Well, yes, of course. There are few magickers in the unit who could claim to rival you. I had doubts about your mentality when you first joined, but those have since been dispelled.
Exactly.
Why do you ask?
Catherine's always treating me like a child, reminding me to pack my food before setting out. Telling me not to go too far out on the front lines. She's so overprotective.
You've known each other a long time, haven't you? If she met you when you were a child, I can see how she might still see you that way.
But now I'm a soldier, and I can protect her.
Ah, I see how it is.
Huh? What do you mean?
Oh, nothing. Ignore me.
Hey, come on, what kind of ideas are you getting? It's not like that, you're barking up the wrong tree.
Don't worry, I won't tell.
You won't? Okay.
Something feels off lately. Don't you think, Rhys?
Off? What do you mean?
The mood among the blue foxes. Everyone is so uptight. My sense of rage under the surface. We've grown bigger and more prestigious. We ought to be better off than before. But for some reason, I'm feeling constantly on edge. Do you get that too?
The circumstances are hardly fit for relaxation, given that we face such formidable foes. Besides, we're a group of fighters. This isn't supposed to be a place of tranquility.
I know that, but back when we were founded, well, it just seemed that everyone was much more laid back and joyful.
Listen, Izzy, our battles are only going to become more difficult. I thought we could count on you. But if you don't like the way the units...
Don't you dare finish that sentence, Rhys. I've been with you from the start, and I have my pride as a mercenary and as a swordswoman. I'm sticking with you in Fred till the end, until I breathe my last breath. Got it?
And what if you had to pick between us?
Huh?
Nothing. Forget about it. What is it, Zorawak?
I was just thinking of the day when you and Fred first came to me. One minute you were on my doorstep, famished and bloodied. The next you were declaring your intention to fight as mercenaries.
It was Fred's father, Arlim, who told us to go to you. He said you were old friends. The journey nearly killed us many times over.
Yes, you seemed ready to fall over at any moment. But you had a fire in your eyes.
Fred more than I, to be sure. His family had just been murdered, after all.
Nay, I saw more fire in you.
Really?
Neither rage nor obsession, but a cool, unshakable, unwavering spirit. And it seems to have persisted to this day.
What are you trying to say, Zorawak?
I'm just glad you'll have my back, that's all.
Is that so? Iska, we must prepare to deploy. There are more rioters.
What is their complaint this time?
They claim to be clamoring for democracy, though perhaps that is merely a pretext. According to our scouts, all that is really going on is the usual looting.
More violence without justification, then. Very well. I'll get ready. I just hope you aren't twisting the scout's words for your own ends.
Go and see for yourself.
I'm sure you'll be proved right. You always are.